Hello friends, welcome back to Relief Tutorials. Today we are going to discuss question number 4 of exercise 8.1. Here it is given 15 cot A is equals to 8, you have to find sine and sec. So before starting our problem, what is given here you see, we have 15 cot A is equals to 8, so therefore cot A is equals to 8 upon 15. So we have trigonometric ratio of cot A. Now from cot we have to reach sine and sec. I told you we are not going to use Pythagoras method. So we will use this identities. Now what we have cot. So from cot you know the pair of cot is cosec. So from cot you can reach to cosec by using this identity. Or cot A equal to 8 by 15. So reciprocal of cot is tan. So I can write this also. Therefore tan A is equals to 15 by 8. Reciprocal of cot theta is tan theta. So if cot A is 8 by 15, then tan A is its reciprocal. So 15 by 8. Now we have tan. So now from tan we can find out sec. Here, see how. Now we have sec square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. So we have tan, so we can find sec. How? Sec square theta is equals to 1 plus tan square theta. You have the value of tan. So one thing, instead of theta, I will write here A. Why? Because in our question, angle is A. So I will write here A. Clear? So sec square is equal to 1 plus 10 square. So moral of the story is we have cot. So either you can use this identity, so you will get cosec theta, or from cot reciprocal of cot is tan, and once we get tan you know here the pair of tan is sec. So we can find sec A. So that is equals to 1 plus tan square A. Tan is 15 by 8. So 15 by 8 the whole square. So that is equals to 1 plus 15 square 225. 8 square 64. So now LCM. LCM will be 64. So here 64 plus 225. So what you will get here? 5 plus 4, 9. Here 6 plus 2, 8. So 289 upon 64. This is the value of sec square. So therefore sec A is equals to root 289 upon 64. So therefore sec A root of 289. So it is root of 17. If we see 17 square, see 7 7 are 14 and carry 4. 1 7 is 7, 4 11. Here 17, 1 9 8 2 289. So we can say the root of 289 is 17. Why? Because 17 square is 289. So 17 upon 64. So 8 square is 64. So we got the value of sec A. But we don't want sec A. We want sin A and sec A. So sorry, we got a sec A. Clear? Now, so we got sec A. Now we have to find sin A. So how we can do that? You see, reciprocal of sec is cos. So therefore I can say here cos A is equals to 8 by 17. Now you got cos. So you got cos. So by using this identity, see this identity, Bundy-Bubbly identity, you have cos. So you will get sin. If you have sin, you will get cos. Clear? Okay. So now sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So sin square theta is equals to 1 minus cos square theta. So that is equals to 1 minus cos square theta. Cos is 8 by 17. So 8 by 17 the whole square. So that is equals to 1 minus 64 upon 17 square. I told you 289. So LCM will be 289 here. So 289 minus 64. So that is equal to 9 minus 5, 4, 5. 8 minus 6, 2, 225 upon 289. This is the value of sin square theta. this is sin square theta. So therefore, sin theta is equals to root. Root of 225 is 50. Root of 289 is 70. So sin theta is 15 upon 7. See, what is the moral of the story? You have caught. So you can use this identity, and pair of caught here in square formula is cosec. So you can find cosec. And once you get cosec, from cosec you can find sin. But here what I have done, cot A is 8 by 15, reciprocal of cot is tan, so tan is equal to 15 by 8. Now here the pair of tan is sec, so I have used this identity, so we can find sec. Once you get sec, the reciprocal of sec, see sec, we got it. Now reciprocal of sec is cos, so sec is 17 by 8, so cos A is 8 by 17, and once you got cos, bubbly, you can find buddy, that is sin. Clear? So, in this way you can do your problem. So, I am going to rub this. Okay. And two more identity I have to discuss with you that will be helpful in many cases. See friends. One thing I want to explain, see, if I say tan A into cos A, product of these two ratios, so you know that tan A means sin A upon cos A, I told you, tan theta, sin theta upon cos theta, into here what you have cos A, so cos A will get cancelled, so that is equals to sin A. So moral of the story is, sin A is equals to tan A into cos A. How do you remember this? Tan, you say tan. Tan means sin upon cos. And when you multiply with cos, tan means sin upon cos. And when you multiply with cos, cos cos will get cancelled. So what you will get? Sin. So I can say sin A is equals to tan A. Tan means sin upon cos multiply by cos. Cos cos will get cancelled. So you will get sin. So sin A is equals to tan A into cos A. Similarly, if I say cot A, cot means cos upon sin, so multiply by sin. So cot means cos A upon sin A and multiply by sin A. Sin A, sin A will get cancelled. So what you will get? Cos. So I can say here now cos A is equals to cot A. Cot means cos upon sin. So in denominator you will get sin. So you have to multiply with sin. So sin sin will get cancelled into sin. This is the second identity. In some case we can use this. See, moral of a story. Sin and cos A, these are the two basic ratio I told, sin and cos. Clear? So sin A and cos A. If you don't want here A, you can write theta. It will be very easy to remember you. Angle can be any angle, A, B, C, so I am writing theta in order to avoid the confusion. Tan theta is equals to tan theta. Tan theta means sin upon cos. So in denominator we have cos, so you have to multiply with cos. See here. I got it. Cot A means cos upon sin. So here there is sin. Sin cell cancel, so you get cos. Same thing here. Tan A into cos. Tan means sin upon cos. So in denominator we have cos, so you have to multiply with cos. Cos cos will get cancelled. Sin. So these are the two identities we will use whenever it is necessary. Okay, I hope you understood this. So now we will approach further. So we have done question number 4. Now we will do question number 5. See here, question number 5. Sec theta is equal to 13 by 12. Find all ratios, all trigonometric ratio, T ratios. So what is given here? Sec theta is given. Any ratio will be given. Here sec theta is given. So reciprocal of sec theta is cos theta. So you will get cos theta. Cos is bubbly. So if you have cos theta, you can find sin theta. And when you have both sin and cos, you can find tan theta. tan theta is equals to sin theta upon cos theta. So what is necessary is you have to understand this relationship among all the ratios. If any one ratio is given with the help of these identities, you can find remaining all ratios. See, I will show the roadmap. What is given here? Sec theta is given. So from sec, you will find cos theta. Why? Because reciprocal of sec theta is cos theta. So you got cos theta. Once you have cos theta means I told you this pair, multiple pair. Once you have cos theta, you can find sin theta. How? Okay, sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Then from here, you will get sin theta. Sec is given, reciprocal of sec is cos. Once you get cos, from cos you can find sin. Here reciprocal. Here identity, square identity. Why I am telling it square identity? Because there are squares, that's why. Legally it is not termed as square identities. So we got sin. Once we get sin, reciprocal of sin is cosine. So from sin you can find cosine. Now you have sin and cos, so you can find tan theta. How? Tan theta is equals to sin theta upon cos theta. Okay, so you got tan theta. From tan, reciprocal of tan is cot theta. See, this is the roadmap. Have you got it? What is given here? Sec. Reciprocal of sec is cos. Once you get cos, then by using first identity, basic identity, from cos you can find sin. Reciprocal of sin is cosec. Once you have sin and cos, these two basic ratio, you can find tan. Once you get tan, reciprocal of tan is cot. So you got all the six ratios. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Have you got it? Come on, we'll do the problem. See, look here. Sec theta. So here, sec theta is equal to 13 by 12. So therefore, cos theta is equal to 12 by 13. Okay. Now, we have sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. I told you, if we have cos, we can find sin. If you have sin, we can find cos. Bunchy, bubby. Now, cos we have. So, sin square theta is equals to 1 minus cos square theta. So, 1 minus cos theta, 12 by 13. 12 by 13, the whole square. So, 1 minus 12 square, 144. 13 square, 169. LCM, 169. So here 169 minus 144. So you will get 169 minus 144. 25 upon 169. This is the value of sin square theta. This is sin square theta. So therefore sin theta is root. Root of 25. Pi root of 169. 13. So we got sin theta is equal to pi upon 13. So you have cos. You have find out sin by using first square identity. Okay. So now you have sin as well as you have cos. So you can find tan. Simple. Tan theta is equals to sin theta upon cos theta. So that is equals to sin theta. Sin theta is 5 by 13 upon cos theta. Cos theta is 12 by 13. 13, 13 cancel. So therefore, tan theta is equals to 5 by 2. So you got tan theta. And you know, reciprocal of tan theta is cot theta. So directly you can write, therefore, cot theta is equals to 12 by 5. So we got cot theta. See now, how many we got? Cos theta. Sec theta is given, cos theta, 2, 3, 4, 5. One identity is missing. That is, sorry, one ratio is missing, cosec theta. So now also, cosec theta is 1 upon sin theta. Cosec theta is reciprocal of sin theta. Sin theta 5 upon 13. So therefore, cosec theta is 13 upon 5. Have you got it? So in this way, by using trigonometric identity, we can solve this problem. We are not following Pythagoras method. This problem can also be done by Pythagoras. So I hope you enjoyed this problem. Now we will do next question. See, I am doing question number 7.
6 will be left.
Cot theta is equal to 7 by 8. Find 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta upon 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta. Very important problem. It was asked many times in board. So we can mark this question as an important question. Question number 7. Very important question. Now question RIC. You have to find the value of these ratios. What you have got. So what will be first thought in our mind? Okay, we will find the value of sine and we will find the value of cos. How we can do that? See, cot theta. So you go here, cot theta. The pair of cot is cosine. So from cot, what you will get? You will get cosine. See, we have cos x square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1. So cos x square theta is equals to 1 plus cot square theta. You have the value of cot theta, you will substitute here, you will get cosine. So from this, you will get cosine. And once you get cosine, reciprocal of cosine is sine. So you can find sine. Okay, leave it that side. Now you have to find cos. So from sine, if you want to find cos, this is bunting. This is bunting. So you use here sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So cos square theta is equals to 1 minus sine square theta. From this you can find cos theta. So this is the roadmap. Sine and cos. Then you will substitute this value here. And you will solve this. And you will get the value of this ratio. So it is a very lengthy method. But if you have little bit knowledge of algebra, just by looking at this, you can see there is one identity which we can use. I am going to write this. See, what are the identities? So you know, in algebra we will learn one identity. A plus B into A minus B is equal to A square minus B square. You remember this identity? Difference of two perfect square. A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. See here, the first term will be same A, second term will be same BB. Here you see 1, 1, sin theta, plus, minus. So A plus B, A minus B. Got it? So now, before finding any ratio, no need of finding any ratio, just we are going to solve this. See, now 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta upon. In a different manner, we are going to solve this. Okay? See, look here. Now, what do you say based on this algebraic identity? A plus B, A minus B. So A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. So I can say 1 square is 1 minus sin square. A square minus B square. Here also same thing. See here 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta. A plus B, A minus B. So A square minus B square. Clear? Now, here we have squares. So whenever there are squares, just go through this identity. Sine and cos, so we have this identity. So I can say sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So sine square goes there. So 1 minus sine square theta is equals to cos square theta. So I can write here now 1 minus sine square theta. See here. 1 minus sine square theta is equals to cos square. Same thing. 1 minus cos square theta. See, 1 minus cos square theta is equals to sin square theta. Now cos square theta upon sin square theta. I told you, what is cot theta? Cot theta is equal to cos theta upon sin theta. So cos square theta upon sin square theta is equal to cot square theta.
And you know what is cot theta?
Yes.
7 upon 8. So I can write here 7 upon 8 the whole square. So that is equals to 49 upon 64. So no need of finding value of trigonometric ratio sin theta and cos theta. Just by mere observation, you can say that here we can use algebraic identity a plus b, a minus b. So that is a square minus b square, a plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square. Now trigonometric identity, 1 minus sin square theta, 1 minus sin square theta is equals to cos square theta. 1 minus cos square theta, see 1 minus cos square theta is equals to sin square theta. Cos square upon sin square, again trigonometric identity. If you want, I can write here, see cot theta is equals to cos theta upon sin theta. So I can write here cot square theta, and cot square theta, cot theta you have there, I will just substitute. Have you got it? Very simple. Again, I will write this. This is question number 1. Now, it says question number 1, second one. What is second one? See here, I will write this. You have to find second one. It is given in your textbook. You have to find cot square theta, but there is a mistake in your textbook. Not cot square theta, find cosec square theta. You have to find cosec square theta. So how you will find it? What you have got? You have to find cosec square theta. So look here. Okay? So you can use this. So you will get cosec square theta. Square identity. We have cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1. So cosec square theta is equals to 1 plus cot square theta. So that is equals to 1 plus cot square theta, cot theta, 7 by 8 the whole square. So 1 plus 49 upon 64. So LCM will be 64. So here 64 plus 49. So answer will be 9 plus 4, 3, carry 1, 113 upon 64. This is the value of cosec square theta. Have you got it? You have got, you have to find cosec. So see, there is a pair, cosec square theta minus cos square theta. You have got, you can find cosec. So this identity is quite important. Clear? So we have solved this one. Now we will do next problem, that is question number 8. Okay, see what we have. 3 cot A is equals to 4, check. 1 minus tan square A upon 1 plus tan square A is equals to cos square A minus sin square A. You have to check this. See friends, here cot A is given. We have 3 cot A is equals to 4. So therefore cot A is equals to 4 by 3. Now in order to solve this, like in the previous problem, we were having this algebraic identity, but here there is no such identity. Okay, so I am going to do this. So it means you have to find the value of tan, you have to find value of cos and sin. Then you will substitute here in LHS and RHS. If both are equal, then we can say it is true. So it means we have to find tan A, we have to find cos A, we have to find sin. Okay, come on, see. Cot A we have. So reciprocal of cot is tan. So therefore I can say tan A is equals to 3 by 4. We got tan. So we got this tan here. So we can solve now LHS by substitute the value of tan A here in LHS. But in order to solve RHS, you require cos and sin. So it is necessary, first we will find the value of cos and sin. Question arises, how we will find cos and sin from tan A?
So you might be knowing that. I told you that. See. So what we will do here, we will find tan we have. So pair of tan is set. We will use this identity. So now we have sec square a minus tan square a is equals to 1. So sec square a is equals to 1 plus tan square a. So that is equals to 1 plus tan 3 by 4 the whole square. So that is just 1 plus 3 square 9, 4 square 16, LCM 16, here 16 plus 9. So that is just 25 by 16 is the value of sec square. So therefore sec square a is equal to 25 by 16. So sec square a is equal to 25 by 16. So therefore the reciprocal of sec is cos. So I can write here cos square a is equal to 16 by 25. And we want cos square a itself. No need of finding cos a. Directly we are getting cos square, so we will use this cos square. Okay. So now you got cos square. Now you have to find sin square. So once again, we will use this identity. Why? We have cos, so we can find sin. So I can write here now sin square a plus cos square a is equals to 1. So sin square a is equals to 1 minus cos square a. So that is just 1 minus cos square is 16 upon 25, LCM 25. So here what you will write, 25 minus 16, so 9 upon 25 is the value of sin square a. See, sin a is equals to 3 by 5, but we don't want sin a, we want sin square a itself. So no need of finding sin a. Okay, so I am not finding this sin. So now we have all the raw material which we require. See, we have value of tan square a, tan a. So tan is 3 by 4. So tan square a is 9 by 16. So we have tan square a, we have cos square a, and we have sin square a. Please. Have you got it? So we have now all the basic values. So now we will prove LHS and RHS. Okay. Now, shall I run this? So, first we will write LHS. What is LHS here? 1 minus tan square a upon 1 plus tan square a. So, that is equals to 1 minus, see tan is 3 by 4, so therefore I can write tan is 3 by 4, okay. So therefore tan square a is equals to 9 by 16, okay. So I can write here 1 minus 9 by 16, 1 plus 9 by 16. So here LCM will be here 16, here, yeah, numerator. LCM will be 16, so what you will get? 16 minus 9. Here LCM will be 16, so you will get 16 plus 9. 16 minus 9. 16 minus 9 is 7 by 16 upon 16 plus 9, 25 by 16. 16, 16 cancel, so 7 upon 25. So LHS is 7 upon 25. Now we will find RHS. Now RHS. RHS is cos square a minus sin square a. So cos square a, we have the value of cos square, 16 by 25, minus sin square, we have the value of sin square, 9 by 25. So LCM will be 25, 16 minus 9, 7 by 25. 7 by 25, 7 by 25, therefore LHS is equals to RHS. Have you got it? So what is the moral of the story of this problem? What is given? You have to prove LHS is equals to RHS. Cot a. So I told you reciprocal of cot is tan. So we got tan. We want tan square. So tan square. Now from tan we want cosine sin. So you know in square identity the pair of tan is sec. So sec square a minus tan square equal to 1. So you will get sec square. Sec square, reciprocal of sec is cos. So you will get cos square. Once you got cos square a, you can find sin square a. Well, bubbly, funky. First identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So from cos square a, you will find sin square. So all basic requirements which we needed are now available. So now we'll do this. First we have taken LHS, substitute the value of tan square a here and solve it algebraically, we will get 7/25. Then we'll go for RHS. We have cos square a, we have sin square a, we'll substitute the value, solve it algebraically and we will get 7/25. So both LHS is equals to RHS, means this is true. I hope you enjoyed this problem. See, now we'll do 10th problem. 9th problem of your textbook will be done after completing second exercise. Okay? See now, what is given here? In triangle PQR, angle Q is 90 degree. So here in triangle PQR, angle Q is 90 degree. PQ plus QR is 25. PQ is 5. This is 5 centimeters. You have to find sin P, cos P and tan. This you have to find out. This is question. Now see, in this right angle triangle, we have only one value. We don't have any other value. If we have two values, by using Pythagoras, we can find the third side of a triangle. But here only we have one side of a triangle, so we can't use Pythagoras. So now, but here one relation is given. PR plus QR is equals to 25. That is, PR plus QR is equals to 25. So I can write here now. PR plus QR is equals to 25. Let, we suppose PR is equals to X. PR plus QR, sum of these two is 25. So we have supposed one value, PR is equals to X. So I can write here X plus QR is equals to 25. So therefore QR is equals to 25 minus X. So this I have taken X. So this I got 25 minus X. So moral of the story is, now we have three sides. Among these three sides, only one thing is missing, that is X. So now we can use Pythagoras. Why? Because only one value is missing. So now, therefore, according to Pythagoras, what we can say here, now see, PQ square plus QR square is equals to PR square. PQ is 5 square. QR is 25 minus X, the whole square, is equals to X square. So look at this equation. In this whole equation, only one thing is missing, that is X. I told you repeatedly, see, if I say 2X is equals to 16, in this whole equation, only one thing is missing, X. So you will be able to find this value. So X is equals to 16 by 2, so X is equals to 8. So moral of the story is, in an equation, if only one variable is there, or one thing is missing, you can find out by solving that equation. Same thing here, in the whole equation there is only one thing. Now this, look here, a minus b the whole square. So you might be knowing that a minus b the whole square, a square minus 2ab plus b square. This is the basic identity. Now 5 square, 25, plus a minus b the whole square, a square, a square is 25 square. So I can write 625 minus 2ab. Means 2 into a, a is 25, into b, b is x, 2 into 25x, so that is equals to 50x, clear? So minus 2a, now plus b square, so b is x, so I can write here x square is equals to, now 25 plus 6 is 25, so I will get 650, this x square will get cancelled. Minus 50x when it goes on other side is equals to 50x. Now x we have to find out. 50 is in multiplication. It will go here in division. So 650 upon 50 is equals to x. So therefore 0, 0 cancel here. I can say now 5 1s are 5 1 30 is equals to x. So we got the value of x. Now if you have value of x, you can find these two sides. So now therefore I can say here. Therefore, PR is equals to X, that is equals to 30. Now, QR is equals to 25 minus X. So, 25 minus 13, so that is equals to 12. 5, 12, 13. See, 5, 12, 13. We know that it is a triplet of right angle triangle. Pythagoras triplet. So if it is 5, naturally this will be 12 and this will be 13. Why? Because hypotenuse is the longest side. Clear? Now we have measures of all three sides of a triangle. So now we can find all the ratios. Now,
sine P. Sine is opposite upon hypotenuse. P is in this angle here. Opposite. Opposite is QR upon hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is PR. So QR is 12. Hypotenuse PR is 13. So we got sine P. Now we will find cos P. Cos adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent is PQ. Hypotenuse PR. So PQ is 5 upon 13. So we got cos P. Now you find tan P. Tan opposite upon adjacent. Opposite is QR. Adjacent is PQ. QR. QR is how much? 12. PQ is 5. Or you can say tan P is sin P upon cos P. You find the ratio of these two. See, if you find the ratio, 13, 13 cancel. Answer will be 12 by 5. Clear? So I hope you enjoyed our lecture. Just go through each and every problem. But before that, once again, you have to go through all the identities in a pattern which I have explained you. Please follow the identities, learn the identities. Then this chapter will be quite easy. Okay? So it's enough for today.